Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Lawrence at Home. My name is Teacher Bia, and I am going to be your storyteller for today. Today on Stories and STEAM, we're going to be learning the story of a scientist called Caitlín R. Kiernan. But before we get started with today's story, I want to invite you to subscribe to our channel if you want to see more videos from us, and if you would like to share this video with others, since learning is more fun when we do it together, make sure to give this video a like and maybe even share it with a friend. Now let's go ahead and get started with today's story. So today we're going to be learning a little bit of the story of Caitlín R. Kiernan. All right, so Caitlín R. Kiernan is a paleontologist as well as a science fiction and dark fantasy author. Interesting. Have you ever heard of a paleontologist before? What kind of scientist is a paleontologist? Do you have any idea of what they do? Maybe you've heard of paleontologists before. Maybe you even know a paleontologist. Paleontologists are scientists that study the history of life on Earth through investigating the fossil record. By looking at the remains of animals that used to exist on Earth that got buried underground, paleontologists can learn more about the lives of the life forms that existed on Earth before we did. But Caitlín Kiernan isn't only a paleontologist. They are also an author, which means they write and publish books. Some people can be many things at once, and Caitlín Kiernan is both a scientist and an author. I wonder if being a scientist sometimes informs their author work, or maybe being an author can help them be a better scientist. That's a very interesting question to ask. Now let's take a closer look in the story and learn a little bit about how Caitlín grew up. So Kiernan was born in Ireland, and after their father passed, they moved to Alabama with their mother and younger sister. You can see on this top map over here where Ireland is. Ireland is located in an island in Europe. But after their father passed away, they moved to the United States with their mother and younger sister. And they moved to Alabama near a city called Birmingham, where they spent a lot of their life. Growing up, they became interested in archaeology, herpetology, and fiction writing. So a lot of the subjects that are very related to the professions that they grew to have were things they were passionate about as kids. Archaeology refers to the study of human history through excavations, and herpetology refers to the study of amphibians like frogs and salamanders, as well as reptiles like snakes, lizards, and turtles, for example. And from a young age, they were also interested in writing. As a teen, they volunteered at the Red Mountain Museum in Birmingham, Alabama, where they gained experience in archaeology and paleontology even before finishing high school. So by volunteering and working at the Red Mountain Museum, which was a science center much like our dear Lawrence Hall of Science, they gained some experience on these areas they were interested in even before finishing high school. Let's see what happens next in their story. Caitlín studied geology and vertebrate paleontology at the University of Alabama at Birmingham and at the University of Colorado at Boulder. After graduating, they returned to Red Mountain Museum, now as staff. They worked as a museum staff as well as a teacher. Then later, in 1984, Kiernan co-founded the Birmingham Paleontological Society. Over their career, they wrote multiple papers describing many different animals, but a lot of their paleontological work specializes in the study and description of different species of mosasaurus. Mosasaurus are really interesting animals. They are marine reptiles, meaning that they are reptiles that live underwater. Over here in the pictures, you can see a mosasaurus skull, as well as the recreation of what a mosasaurus animal would look like when they were alive. There are many different variations of mosasaurus around the world, and some of them would grow to be really big. For a lot of their paleontological work, Kiernan would make use of a strategy called biostratigraphy that consists in looking at the kinds of fossils that are in certain layers of rock, that are represented over here on this image as well. And by looking at the age of the fossils, the scientist is able to find out the age of that layer of rock. But as we learn in our story, Kiernan was not only a scientist and an excellent paleontologist, they were also an author. So now let's take a step back and take a look at their author work to finish today's story. Kiernan is also a multiple award-winning author. They have written multiple science fiction and dark fantasy novels, short stories, and comics. Although a lot of people identify their genre as horror, they describe their work as psychological fiction or awe fiction, with some horror elements throughout. So a lot of the stories that they write actually have a horror element and are pretty spooky. One of the things that Kiernan's story helps us learn is that people can be both scientists as well as artists and creative and express themselves in a lot of different ways. Kiernan's story helps us realize that a lot of these things can coexist. All right, my friends, this was just a little taste of Caitlín R. Kiernan's story. I hope that you enjoyed learning about this paleontologist and author, and that they inspire you to follow multiple passions all at the same time. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of today's video. I hope that you enjoyed today's story. If you want to see more science videos from us, make sure to subscribe to our channel and give this video a like. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time here at The Lawrence at Home. Bye-bye!